Everybody, welcome to the second episode of CWA. Before we get started, let's go over what happened at the previous episode. Leon Woods put his CWA World Heavyweight Championship on the line against Isaiah Washington in his second defense, which ended in a burning hammer finish after 12 minutes and 57 seconds. It was a good match, only getting a 70% rating by Duke Frost, Jimbo, and The Butcher, which are our main raters for these matches in our shows. And after the match, Leon Woods tried to offer a handshake, but getting rejected. After Isaiah Washington rejected the handshake out of spite in the show of bad sportsmanship, he also got attacked backstage by Jason King after getting interviewed on why that happened. Jason King's whereabouts at the moment are not at all known, as well as the fact that we don't even know why Jason King even attacked Isaiah Washington. But afterwards, the CWA World United States Champion, inaugural champion, was crowned. And that would be Alan Phantom at a 73% rating for the matches. Currently, Jimbo did not like the storytelling that much. To be fair, there was no story to be told. There was just three men duking it out. After 19 minutes and 54 seconds, Alan Phantom puts another championship under his belt. Progressing on through the night, we started our two tournaments, the CWA Women's Intercontinental Championship Tournament and the Men's Junior Heavyweight Championship Tournament. First match of those tournaments being Sage McKenzie versus YZK. And Jimbo is currently kind of stale with this 6 out of 10. I mean, not too much story to be told there, so understandably, but after a good dominating performance, the match did get a 63%, but still a good performance from the two women nonetheless. Afterwards, we saw the Diamond Boy, Kenny Carter, debuting, introducing himself and pretty much laying it out, saying he was one of the people backstage that worked on the Junior Heavyweight Championship and yearning to be the inaugural Creed Junior Heavyweight Champion. And speaking of that championship, the men's tournament, we saw Ryu Hayabusa going head to head with Ray Santos, which this might be the second match of the night, because both men went through it. They went back to back. You can even see Butcher had a 9 out of 10 with his physicality. He's a physical man if you saw his matches. And yeah, we have a 77%, and after 12 minutes and 24 seconds, we saw one of the most dominating finishes with him choking him out. And in the last part of the episode, we saw two UCW's renowned superstars, Cody Hawk and Tom Dyer, talking back and forth, also announcing that they are now active members of CWA. But that celebration got cut short after Tom Dyer kind of proposed a thought of him going after Cody Hawk's UCW Television Championship, which Cody Hawk was two steps ahead, as well as the fact that he didn't come alone. He debuted alongside the Syndicate, making them a trio now, and Lord knows what they're up to. And in the main event, which got a 83%, pretty much match of the night, we have the Fatal 4-Way Gauntlet match to see who will be the inaugural CWA World Women's Heavyweight Champion. And we saw it all on display. Petra Rica, Elizabeth Evans, Kimiko, and Taryn Sparks tore the house down. You can even see in the ratings that Duke Frost, Jimbo, and Butcher all equally liked this match, going to a 83%. And after 34 minutes and 33 seconds, we have the inaugural CWA World Heavyweight Women's Champion, none other than Taryn Sparks, the Acolyte, adding another title to her collection. And now we're seeing breakout star of the night, match of the night, performance of the night, and the MVP, the most valuable player of the night, breakout star being Isaiah Washington, who went head-to-head against Leon Woods. I mean, makes sense. He pretty much kicked out one of Leon's burning hammers. So, he has a lot going for him. But after he got attacked by Jason King, we're not too sure if he'll be here tonight. Match of the night being none other than the Fatal 4-Way Gauntlet match, of course. At 83%, all four women, like I said, tore the house down. Pretty much had a really good performance. Speaking of performance, Elizabeth Evans lasted 24 minutes and 39 seconds in that gauntlet, being, you know, the longest. Pretty much putting her whole body on the line, trying to get towards Taryn Sparks. But she did not succeed. But she did pull off a good performance. MVP being, of course, your inaugural CWA World Heavyweight Women's Champion, Taryn Sparks. And to conclude that episode 1 of CWA, a new federation, the overall rating being a 77% out of 99.9%, one of the highest in this entire universe mode. We see Duke Frost on pacing, giving a very generous number of 30.3%, but I do understand why. Perfectly paced throughout each part. And a Butcher on match quality being the lowest rated here, as well as Jimbo on story development. And next up, we're going to be seeing your general manager, Jasmine Creed, making a few announcements. Afterwards, we'll be hearing from Taryn Sparks, currently holding that championship for 91 days, about to get to 100. Everybody, welcome to the second episode of CWA. Here is your general manager, Jasmine Creed, who introduced herself last episode, who booked an amazing first episode. After all, she got a few things to say. And here comes your inaugural CWA World Women's Champion, Taryn Sparks. And wow, some amazing news from Jasmine Creed. SSW and CWA currently tied with the best debuting first episode.
And Taryn Sparks just set out an open challenge for her CWA World Women's Championship right off the bat. And not only that, to anybody from any company. And not just the CWA roster. This is a big opportunity, and I could kind of see this happening for even more. More opportunities. Inaugural versus inaugural. The inaugural UCW Women's Champion, Kelly Fox, making her way to in CWA. I'm not sure for how long, but I know she's out for a championship, so I can tell she's gonna be here for a while. If she wins, that is. But who knows? You got the likes of Tom Dyer, Cody Hawk. Who know? And here we go, the CWA World Women's Championship on the line. This is her first defense, and it's one of a big way. By chance, this is a... My goodness. I'm just astonished. Taryn Sparks has got a lot to go up against here. Kelly Fox, pretty good in the ring. One of the best in-ring performers in UCW. Taryn Sparks starting off her championship reign with a bang. Already immediately wanting to defend it against anyone. This is a champion right here. First defense. Taryn Sparks, Kelly Fox. Championship rules. We got a 60-minute time limit. Here we go. Here's the kick. Crucifix head scissors by Kelly Fox. And a nice, another head scissors. Oh, nice. Catching that leg, Taryn Sparks. Sparks with a German suplex. Oh. Sending her into the corner. Kicks to the side of the hip. Or the side of the abdomen. Going after the double axe handles right in the corner. Just demolishing her. Taryn Sparks getting out of the corner. And a nice brain buster there by Kelly Fox. Taryn Sparks not having the best time here. Like I said, she got a lot to go against here. This is Kelly Fox, the inaugural UCW Women's Champion. Kick to the gut. Roundhouse kick. Send her back into that corner. Knee. Oh, Taryn Sparks now. Oh, now Kelly Fox getting back. On offense. Leapfrog. Oh, pump forearm. My goodness. Missing that. Catching her. Grabbing her hair. Kick. Oh, right to the gut. Missing the clothesline. Drop kick right to the head by Kelly Fox. Oh, getting a rope break right under, I think, her leg. Kelly Fox. She looks like she hasn't skipped a beat. It's been, what, how many years? Two now? Nice crossbody by your champion. Making it to the two count. Oh, miss. Oh, goodness. A knee to the gut. Missing that. I don't know what she was going for. I think a knee again. Missing that. These two are going back and forth. These two haven't missed a beat. Discus chop by Kelly Fox. Going for something big here. Corkscrew moonsault. But it only makes it to the two count. She's going after the back now. Nope. Targeting an arm. Technical offense here. Not much you see it from Kelly. She's a striking performer with knees to the back. Proving what I just said. Oh, she looks like she was going for that knee. Oh! Beautiful strategy here. Getting into that corner just in time. Nice butterfly suplex. Trying not to keep her up. Just trying to keep her down as best way she can. So you got to do something like that when it comes to Kelly Fox. The fast offense. The fast maneuver she has. Even her reversals are swift. Here goes Kelly Fox with a belly to belly. With amazing strength. Look at that. She's going for something. A knee. Not even letting her get up. Usually she lets them get up, but only making a one count. Just off a whim. Close to the two. As smooth as fast. Oh! Taryn Sparks had it just mapped out, reversing the Zorro finale. Nice little power slam there. Reversing the power slam, not the power slam, the Zorro finale with a nice arm strike. Oh! Another corkscrew! Not corkscrew, crucifix! I'm still thinking about that corkscrew moonsault. Combinations here. Kick to the legs. There we go. And now double axe handle. Taryn Sparks a little tired here. Going against the likes of... Oh, Kelly Fox going on the outside. Probably not what Taryn Sparks had in mind, but she has to go for something else. Nice clothesline on the outside. These two have been using a lot of strategy here. Keeping her back in that corner. Nice tree of woe position. Taryn Sparks. A taste of her own medicine here. Double foot stomp. And a German. One, two, kick out of two. Just getting out of it. Oh, going after the arm now. Like I said, a taste of her own medicine. But Kelly Fox getting out of it. Being known for getting out of... Oh, goodness! Catching the knee! Taryn Sparks tried to go for that... Wow. Spine buster! I can't even keep up with these two. My goodness. And a nice old punt kick. Taryn Sparks just has to go out at the ring. Kelly Fox not letting up. She wants this championship. Goodness! Powerbomb! Oh my goodness. Took a little bit time. Took her time with that one. She wasn't expecting all that force from that picking up that power bomb. and going for a drop kick. Oh, jeez, that landing was dangerous. And now, oh, she ran out of stamina. Yeah, like I said, I think Kelly Fox got her tired out. Kelly Fox got a lot of stamina.
Oh,
getting the gut kick, but getting caught. A nice moonsault. I don't even think she had enough stamina to get out the way. But only getting one count. What does Kelly Fox have to do here? I know what Taryn's trying to do. Going after that arm again. Oh, clothesline. And a nice calf kick. Going after the knee. I mean, not the knee. Going after the back with a kick. Kick to her head. Scottish sicko. Clothesline to the back. Nice dodge. She tried to get it. Kick out at two. These two having a lot of near falls. The question is, who's going to have that three count? Who's going to be the CWA world champion by the end of this night? And she's charging up a knee. And oh, immediately, Kelly Fox rolling out the ring. Another Scottish sicko. My goodness. Another kick out. Kelly Fox, they're getting up. Taryn Sparks here, saving her energy. Super kick. Trying to go for the quick kick outs here. I mean, not quick kick outs, pins, but they're leading to kick outs by Kelly Fox. Oh, Irish whip. Nope. Reversal. Kelly Fox now. Returning the punishment. Straight to the back. And a backstabber. Going after the pin. One. Two. Kick out at two. Backstabber got her off guard. Goodness! That caught me off guard. Zero finale. Kick out at two. I wasn't expecting her to get out of that. Missing that. Clothesline. Taryn Sparks. Oh, missing the clothesline. Getting out of the way just in time. Dragon screw. And going after the leg now. Yeah, taking out that leg now. I think Kelly Fox has been studying these matches. That's a trend with our the UCW rosters. They've been trying to study the match, know who they're going against. That's why Taryn Sparks needs to watch out. Because if that leg gets out of it, she won't be able to hit that stomp. Drop kick. Getting out the ring just in time. And a nice spaceman, Tope Con Hilo. And right after it, just stomping right on the outside. My goodness. These two have not let up. The combination is a spaceman drop kick. Kelly Fox getting her back inside the ring. She wanted to end this now. Or maybe not. Going on top. Oh, the ropes. Elbow to the back. Not getting it. Gutbuster. Now going after that arm that she missed with the elbow drop. Going after the leg as well. What a match we have here. Mr. Scottish Sicko. Another brain buster. These two are out of it. What a mess these women are putting up, man. My goodness. This is your World Women's Champion going against the inaugural UCW Women's Champion. Block. Yo, missing the discus. Look at that dodge. Missing that. Going right after the leg to make up for that miss. The combinations. Oh, she's still going after that leg. That's what she has to do. But, going for her submission maneuver here. Now going after her legs and arms. Just the body entirely. Oh, punch to the gut. I mean, not to the gut, to the face. Oh, head scissors, takedown. Classic, vintage, Kelly Fox, the ropes. Taryn Sparks going back on the outside. But a corkscrew moonsault! Kelly Fox is fired up. What a match. What a match. These two are going at it. These two making it to 15. Whiplash neckbreaker. They're fighting all over this ring at this point. Dragging her. I mean, what can they really do? They don't have that much stamina. Even Kelly Fox is running out of. Oh, go! Zora finale. One, two. What a kick out. This is your champion. This is your champion showing resilience, showing heart. Oh, kick out. Clothesline. And a kick out reversal. Sorry. Sling blade. Drop kick right to her this time. My goodness, going back right after that arm. In the leg so she won't be able to hit that knee. What a match, these two are going at it. Oh my goodness. That's two Zorro finales kicked out of. Another clothesline, not connecting fully. German suplex. Release German, taking advantage, getting a rope. What more could she do? What more could she have done? The amount of force that went into that. Fujiwara armbar. Oh, getting out of it. Stop! Boom! One, two. Oh, she tried to get the ropes. She kicked out just in time. The strength. I think she just used the rope to power herself up with that kick out. But a stomp right after. One, two, three. Taryn Sparks, after an amazing, amazing women's match. What a match. All glory to the Heavenly Father. We just witnessed greatness. That was a non-stop. Wow, what a woman's, what an opener. First defense from Taryn Sparks. Oh, I am proud to say this is our woman's champion, full-fledged, right in view of all of you at CWA, Gia Summers, the Jaguar, Mariana Sanja. Not much you see this either, going straight after the arm, German suplex, another, going for it, so, I don't know what that's called, here we're going to be continuing our Creed CWA Intercontinental Women's Championship Tournament. And here we
Nicholas Sokolov,
Kenny Carter.
Punch.
Get him up. And so far. Sleeper. Creed Junior Pro Junior Heavyweights Pro Championship Tournament.